الرحيم. Hello there. My name is Maan. Welcome to the world of AutoCAD. In this tutorial, you will be learning the basics of AutoCAD. I want to show you in this lesson how to use the move command, copy command, and the stretch command. The move command. This AutoCAD command will allow you to move objects at a specified distance in a specified direction. To make a single move of an object, I draw rectangle, for example. On the ribbons home tab, click on the move command, select this object, then press enter. Pick a point on this object to be used as a reference point, endpoint or midpoint. Pick a point which represents the new location of this object. Another example, I draw a circle and click on the move command, select the circle, then press enter. Pick a point on this circle to be used as a reference point, center point or quadrant point. Pick a point which represents the new location of this circle. To make multiple moves of object, in the same way, click on move command, select this object, then press enter. Pick a point as a reference point. I choose the endpoint for this rectangle and pick a point which represents the new location of this subject. The object moves a distance and direction equal to the coordinates specified for the base point. For example, I choose this rectangle, click on the move command, select this object, then press enter. On the command line, press on the displacement. Enter 8, 3, for example, to move this rectangle 8 units to the left, to the right, and 3 units up. Then press enter. Another example, click on the move command, select this object, press enter, and pick this point, this endpoint as a reference point, and type 4 < 45 degrees to move this object 4 units at an angle of 45 degrees counterclockwise from the east. Then press enter. The copy command. The copy command can be used to create one or more duplicates of any drawing object which you previously created. Copy is a very useful and time-saving command because you can create very complex drawing elements and then simply copy them as many times as you like. To make a single copy of an object, I draw, for example, rectangle on the Ribbons Home tab, click on copy command and select this object, then press enter, pick a point on this object to be used as a reference point, and pick a point which represents the new location. Another example, I draw a circle . Click on copy command, select the circle, press enter, pick this center point as a reference point, and pick a point which represents the new location. You can make multiple copies of an object. First of all, the multiple option allows you to create additional copies of the selected object by picking as many new points as you like. For example, click on copy command, select this object and press enter. Pick this end point as a reference point and pick a point which represents the new location. This is copy one, this is the second point, and this is copy two, this is the third point, and this is copy three, and this is the fourth point. Another example, click on copy command, select this object, then press enter, pick this midpoint as a reference point, and on the command line type the second point of a displacement, for example arc 5 less than 0, at 5 less than 90. And at 5, 5. The distance between this midpoint of this rectangle and this midpoint of this rectangle, it is 5. Is useful when you have a line or shape on screen that you want to make longer. For example, click stretch command and select this object with crossing selection and press enter. Pick a point for a base point and pick another point as a new location of the base point. Another example, click stretch command, select this object with the crossing section and then press enter key to end selection. Pick a point for a base point and pick another point as a new location of the base point. There are two ways to change the radius of circle. First way, select the circle and open the properties. Right click and open the properties. And go to the radius and change the radius. For example, change from 30 to 40. You can see the radius now is 40. Second way, select the circle and click on one of the quadrant grips to make it hot. You can see that the circle's radius has been stretched. When I click on the center grab on the circle, my stretch becomes a move. So I am actually displacing the location. Another example, to stretch the elliptical, you see that my current axis is 90 on horizontal and 27 on the vertical. I'm going to click on the vertical axis. I can stretch the minor axis to 75 or 51. My horizontal axis, click on this grab and I can stretch the major axis, for example, to 158. If I click on the center of elliptical, that I can display a location or move my elliptical.